Westbrook against his former teammate.
A great help by Brissett off the right side. He is in great position.
And Sabonis, the rebound on the miss by Westbrook.
Yeah, that was great help by Brissett because Hachimura was in the right corner, and he really is not a guy that's going to make shots. That's where they miss having Beal on the floor, and the Pacers can take advantage of it in their defensive matchups.
LeVert directing traffic. He's got it with six to shoot. Against Gafford.
Gafford's a little tough to beat, Chris. See, he's tougher to beat.
Oh, and they call that on Sabonis. Boy, Gafford came over the back. But the Pacers
already have to challenge one.
Yeah, they don't have a challenge.
Yeah, you don't have a challenge.
18 seconds to play.
Yeah, they don't have a challenge. They got one earlier and made it work. And you can see the contact there.
Pacers got the stop the last time, Quinn. They need a stop to win the game. Westbrook blocked!
That's blocked. He's got to come up with the ball. He got a timeout. Scott Brooks got a timeout when Gafford got the ball.
Pacers got the block, but they couldn't scoop up the loose ball underneath the basket. 8:03 to play. The Wizards will have it to inbound. We'll come back. Pacers lead it 132-131.
Hold fast to dreams. Where dreams go, life is a barren field, frozen with snow.
The lasting cologne scent of Old Spice Dynasty helps get you off your couch and into the driver's seat.
32 lead changes, 10 ties tonight. The Pacers have outscored the Wizards 8-7 in overtime, and they need a third stop. 132-131. They got a stop at the end of regulation as Westbrook missed. They just got the stop on the block shot of Westbrook, but Scott Brooks of the Wizards able to get a timeout. And with 8:03 to play, the Pacers hanging on, leading 132-131.
You need a stop and a rebound. Because I've got to believe that they made that Washington may take it a little early. It's because remember the game was tied at four. So you really just, you had to play solid to get a stop, but you need a stop and a rebound. I think they'll take this shot sometime with maybe 3 seconds, so you've got to make sure you get the rebound. The last one they wanted to take was 0 seconds.
That was their 15th offensive rebound. They've out-rebounded the Pacers 60-49. Bertans. You know who it's going to. It's Westbrook. 7 seconds against Justin Holiday. Westbrook wants the shot. The help comes.
Oh, no. He got fouled. Putsy.
They had Westbrook in a tough shot.
He shot, Chris, he had to shoot it off one leg. I mean, because the double team came. LeVert comes to help out Holiday.
Called for his fourth foul. Westbrook with 2 free throws. He's got 31 points. That one ties it.
They got 2 timeouts. They'll take a timeout. Either way.
Tied at 132.
Yeah, he's...
Pacers.
He's telling the official, we take a timeout. You can get the rebound.
1 second. Westbrook and the Wizards have the lead. 33 points, 19 rebounds, and 15 assists. And Russell Westbrook on a night that he has tied Oscar Robertson. Hits 2 free throws with 1 second to play.
But he gets caught in the trap. And there's a lot going on there, but I don't know how you can argue with it. I'm not sure LeVert was the one that necessarily got him, Chris. Did you see that?
Yeah, you're right. They called it on LeVert. There were two players there. It was Holiday and LeVert, but Westbrook went down.
Yeah, he went down.
Now you have 1 second to play. Plenty of time to catch and shoot. I say plenty of time, okay. But 1 second's not a lot.
Right, I was going to say, part. You got time to catch and shoot, because technically under 3 seconds, 3/10 of a second, you don't. So this is one that's got to pretty much get near the basket. Now, the thing about Nate Bjorkman, we've seen, he's been really good with these out-of-bounds plays. Really good. You know, we've seen out-of-bounds plays where guys have been lined up at the foul line, and next thing you know, there's a guy at the basket with the ball and putting it in.
Pacers had a 131-26 lead. They've been outscored 7-2.
They got it on the sideline, away from the Pacers bench.
And it's T.J. McConnell to inbound.
And they got Gafford on him to try to put some pressure on the pass. Everybody's different with this. Oh, he's right there.
Catches.
Oh, Westbrook got there. Because it looked like it was going to be a clean look from LeVert, who played well. And Washington sneaks out of here, partner.
And May have locked up home court in that play-in situation. They move to ninth. Indiana drops to 10 on a night that Russell Westbrook makes history. Tie Oscar Robertson. And Westbrook gets his second block of the night. The Wizards need extra time for a third straight win against the Pacers. First time they have swept Indiana 3-0 since the 06-07 season. And you can see, when I think the Pacers felt good, they liked what they had gotten, but Westbrook made the play.